Tape is rolling. Let's do this thing.
I dropped a frame.
Zoom Room Video Communications brought to you by the BMC.
Quiet on the set! You're listening to WRFB Radio Free Britannia, and no other freaking better place in the world than Deltona, Florida. Here you are, lunch with no other than the dynamic duo, Laz and Jack.
Greetings, everybody. This is Laz.
And this is Jack. Welcome to another edition of Lunch with Laz and Jack, where we interpret the news so you don't have to.
That's right. Bringing you our own brand of news right here inside Trinity Avatar 5 days a week. That's right. 5 days a week.
Whenever we feel like it.
Season 4. Welcome to today's show, boys and girls. It is Thirsty Thursday, February 21st. We are 1 week out, 2019. Get that in there for the record. We are 1 week out from release 63 here in Trinity Avatar. Eagle, how you doing out there, my friend? How are those coffee mugs? Do you get those okay? I hope you're using them and enjoying them well. Botox, how you doing today? Good to see you guys out there early. Yes. And, let's get this out of the way as well.
What are you getting out of the way?
Got to do the, bust everybody's chops in universe chat and, let them know that we're alive and well every day here.
Yeah.
Very cool. Very cool, Eagle. Use them well, my friend.
And for some reason, Discord's telling me that I've got a red connection. Now it's
red connection. Red alert.
Did you see that we are almost to the tuxedo variant?
I saw that. Things are chugging right along. Ballroom dungeon room is probably what everybody is really getting excited about. I know. I'm enjoying the dungeon rooms and I tell you what, let's get this out of the way first, I started playing with some stuff, and I'm a little miffed over it, but we'll get to that.
Yeah.
R62 stretch goals, currently running all month, all purchases throughout the month now go directly towards the stretch goals. The chart and meter is up there all month long, so you can actively keep track of it. And yes, we quickly passed the formal wedding dress variant and are quickly on our way to the tuxedo variant.
Yes, we are.
Because that ballroom dungeon room. I think we really need to get to the jester's outfit to go at all your, torture room stuff. You need somebody down there in a jester's outfit.
Well, to me, the jester outfit should actually come before the ballroom dungeon.
You would think, yes. Right?
Yeah.
I don't know. I would have thought that would have been even earlier. Twilight Tempest, how are you this evening? This evening. Jeez.
You mean sometime like right after, say, the Jester Mask and Jester Mask Staff?
Buddha Thunk.
Then you've got the jester outfit before the brewing themed basement hatches. Yeah.
Yep. Now, the brewing themed basement hatches, I'm curious as to what those are going to be. I mean, are they going to be...
It's going to be like a beer keg.
Beer, wine, and, you know, spirits symbols on them, I'm going to take a guess. I don't know.
You know, we really, really need some mead in-game.
There is mead in game. We need to be able to make it, though.
Make it. Yeah,
you can only buy it from the NPCs, yes.
Yeah.
You need grog, too. We need some form of grog in game.
Oh, you want some grog in game?
Some real heavy duty grog, yes, yeah. Something with an, you know, the mead and the grog should have intoxication levels well above ale and wine, but slightly below spirits, unless you're talking about some really rotten stuff.
But does the grog improve your fishing better than anything else?
Well, that depends on the quality of the grog, right?
Oh, yeah.
That would be my guess. See, we need, you know, a little bit more refined stuff there. You know, we need to be able to balance. You know, what water was used, what ingredients were used from what region, how long they were done, you know, all that stuff for brewing.
Yeah.
But maybe one day we'll see stuff tweaked down to that level. You know, picking hops that was, you know, grown right along Blood River, or, you know... malt grown in the swamps, you know, I mean, you know.
isn't that I'm a newbie?
I'm a newbie what?
So Caffeine posted a picture inside of Discord of the only reason that he's interested in the jester outfit.
That is. That would be, I'm a newbie.
I'm a newbie.
I'm a newbie. Absolutely.
Yeah, and fortunately in Shroud of the Avatar, someone has a character that is I'm a newbie, and someone has Irma newbie.
Yeah, you know, going back in history, her name wasn't Irma.
Eagle, I love you.
I don't know if you knew that or not, but her name wasn't Irma.
Say that again, Lass.
Her name wasn't Irma.
What?
What? Yeah, hold on.
It was Irma newbie.
Yeah, hold on. No, it was, I think it's imanewbie.com.
Yeah. So now the main characters. I'm a newbie. I'm a doofus. Irma doofus.
Irma doofus.
Irma doofus. Okay, sorry. Sorry.
Eagle. Thank you.
Yes, it was not. It was not Irma newbie. It was Irma doofus.
Irma doofus. Yes, is Eagle letting the dogs out and making it rain there. Thank you very much,
my friend. It is
kind of
funny that we are talking about something from 1999.
Hey, not for nothing. Look at that graphic. I mean, you know, that's still a classic graphic to this day. You know, the backpack alone just, you know, brings back, you know, memories.
Well, I mean, they did try to implement the backpack inside a Shroud. Unfortunately, it was not very functional at all. I think part of it was a scaling issue that was never addressed as far as reagents. They would end up being extremely large inside the backpack, and everything sort of stacked on top of each other, and it was a mess.
It was a mess, just like the original backpack.
Well, the original backpacks you could organize so easily because
you know, I believe that in all truthfulness, we found ways to organize it easily in our own minds. Like, put those unruly things like reagents in a bag that you didn't see because...
Bag in a bag.
They were so ugly and unruly. And certain things only fit in certain places in the backpack. So,
you had bone dude and plate dude.
Bone dude and plate dude. Yes, absolutely. Gotta love that stuff. There was thoughts in our minds when we started out doing NBNN that we might do something along the lines of I'm a newbie type thing where Jack and Laz go out and always get cremated by the dragon, you know, something like that.
Hey, I want the Bob and Fred Wars to come back because that
Bob
was
and Fred Wars.
That was hilarious. And then the Orc Guild. You remember them out by the Orc Fort?
My favorites were still always the PKs. The Orc Guild was cool, but.
If you're gonna bring back the PKs, you need to bring back precasting, and then from there that'll make everything so much better.
Boom, you're dead.
Yep. Yeah.
You always had to help the Orc Guild. That's funny.
Yeah.
That's funny. But anyway, moving right along is dungeons and such. Have you had a chance to play with your new Duke rewards?
No.
No?
I've had a chance to play with them, but have I? No.
Well, as I broke mine out, and I went ahead and placed my nice little Duke dungeon room, and I went out and I got my pavers out, and I rushed and got them all together, and I got one for the Cult of Bob, one of the giant ones, and I got one for the Purple Dragon Inn, and rushed down to my dungeon to place these and see how magnificent they would look, only to find out that my giant paver had 12 smaller pavers on it with the image instead of one giant paver with the image on it.
Wait. You kind of broke up when you were saying that.
Shall we go take a look and explain?
Might as well. Where are we going to?
We're going to take a
We're going into your dungeon.
We're
going
to take a quick run down to the dungeon. So if anybody here on the lot wants to join us.
Okay. So enter dungeon, not the sample dungeon.
Not the sample dungeon. That's right.
The dungeon.
Come on.
And let's see if this loads in 15 seconds. I'm going to go with no. Well, came pretty close. So we've got Purple Dragon Inn. I see Cult of Bob.
Okay, so this right here is my giant paver. That's one paver.
Why did they do it like that?
I have no clue. I assume that the giant paver would be a single paver like this one. That would be a giant paver, not 12 pavers together. I mean, what a disappointment this was.
Did you bug report this?
I have not yet because...
Okay.
I just found this out, and I was like, man, this sucks.
Yeah. Hold on. I'm going to change the server.
You know what?
I'm going to change the server because you're cutting out really bad.
Again, I reset some things today. I can probably fix that in a heartbeat. I know it's probably this here. Yeah. Because the input sensitivity was set awful high on default. That should fix it for you big time. Big time!
Yeah. And then you do have some crackling and some other things.
But yeah, this was a pure disappointment here. I mean, a giant paver was, you know, expected to be a giant paver, not the giant paver with 12 small pavers in it. I mean, I was expecting my heraldry to be the centerpiece of the room, one giant piece. And I put this down and I go, man, that sucks. And of course, let's just take a trip down. I put the room down here.
Through the blue axe.
Yeah.
Through the other blue axe.
I was, you know, planning to do the same with the Cult of Bob have the giant bunny on this and nothing, you know, so. Don't know if it's a bug. I'm going to put this out there to any of you other.
Yeah, definitely bug report this because this should be like one massive. They should all be massive.
This is the large paver, which is the other example. This should be just a larger. It shouldn't be four. I haven't played but any of the other pavers to know whether they all. I guess they all do this. Maybe I haven't played.
I think
any
they're
pavers.
All going to look like that.
Yeah,
that's sad. That's sad. It's making me cry.
But yeah,
I don't have permission to click on the blue. Blue things.
No, you don't have permission to edit the dungeon. Speaking of dungeon editing, while we're down here, of course, that is the hot topic. Let's get back up to, or we can, you can put mailboxes down here. Yeah, I have seats down here. We could actually, I'm telling you, we can actually do shows down in a perfectly lighted room.
Without the weather.
Yeah, I don't have weather on my screen. Remember?
I know because you run in shit graphics.
Now Twilight saying by large or giant they mean the size of the paver itself, not the design on the paver.
But the design on the paver should be mammoth. It really should.
I mean, that's just, you know, I mean, it's a giant paver. So if this is a regular paver with a single image on it, a giant paver should have a single image on it with a bigger image. I mean, that just only makes sense. I mean, that's just me. So, yes, NBNN on location. What do you think about that?
I know who we can complain to. It's a guy by the name of List.
You think there's a guy we might know there?
But you don't have the instruments inside your dungeon yet.
Well, you know, this is just proof of concept type stuff. I'm playing with it right now.
Well, do you have your bathtub?
Yes, the swimming pool is off to the left here. We can go take a big bath, and there's actually room to put chairs.
Eventually, they're
going to
get a better swimming animation done too.
Water's got to look a little better in this room. I think the blue for this color was just we can do a shot just swimming here, doing nothing. It's floating in air.
I would love to be able to swim down and up and drown.
One of these days. No drowning.
One of these days.
No drowning.
Yes, we need drowning. And then we need
D&D Online have drowning? If you stayed down too long, your character would belly up. I don't remember underwater swimming in UO. So.
And you have a fishing hole.
I don't know if that's a fishing hole. I think that's just the...
Nope, it's not.
Yeah. That's just something. It's a temporary placeholder. Again, these are just...
It's not a fishing hole.
I have the fishing hole. I have the mine card out in Snug. But,
Well, you need the entire mine dungeon anyways. Which will be
coming. That's what I'm going to do. I got the bigger property out there since this is only a town lot. I figured I'd just make this personal. This will be the man cave dungeon, and then I'll make a dungeon out in the towns.
I have zero mail right now.
What's that?
I have zero mail. Zero mail.
You have no mail.
Well, I checked it before the show, so yeah.
But yes, let's get back up. I feel like a fish out of water down here. Like Jay and Silent Bob leaning up against a different storefront. Just not the same, you know. But yeah, man, how bummed I was when I got that together and laid it down to look at it and go, WTF, guys, really? This is supposed to be special. This is a makeup. This is, you know, make us feel good about this replacement reward. And I just don't get it, man. I don't get it.
Yep. Lot access limited while decorations load.
It was a topic the other day. Somebody was asking about
back to the mess. Yeah. Yes. Back to the mess.
Somebody was asking whether their video card was causing that to happen or whether it happened to everybody else. And the answer, of course, is it happens to everybody while you're waiting. There is a little bottleneck.
Yep.
So anyway, is being down in the dungeons and taking a trip down, hot topic this week, or should I say, not so hot of a topic, community live stream is player-made dungeons, and of course it's player-made dungeon spawning.
Spawning.
Coming up tomorrow's live stream. And we're going to actually, I guess, Chris is going to show us proof of concept of the spawning dungeons and being able to turn that on, turn that off. I do not know exactly, but I do know that there's going to be spawning. You're going to be able to place your dungeon supposedly this coming release and have those rooms that have spawners in them active. And go down and play in your custom-built dungeons. So tune in tomorrow for that, because it should be interesting. Yeah,
it's going to be cool.
Still a couple kinks. I think they've got to do a little bit more polish on connections with between the different types so that they mesh a little bit better. There's still some connections when you put them together. As you run up and down the hallway, you can see through the connectors into the void, as it may be. But so far so good. I'm enjoying the system and having fun with it. But man, again, man, those pavers were a bummer, man. That's all I gotta say.
Yeah, it happens, man. It happens.
Real quick, I want to jump to, I put a link into the NBNN's YouTube here earlier today.
Into the YouTube channel? Why would I look at the YouTube channel?
Well, so that you can show the comments.
Well, now I got to go find that comment. Yeah. What? I get distracted by the Humble Bundle from Pathfinder with all the 10th anniversary books, because that's a lot of books that you can get for $18. Scrolling up, Rolling Stone. Nope. Okay, I think I found it. So we're just looking at the comments, right?
Yeah, just new commenter, Jason Thorne. Jackson Thorne, sorry. Jackson.
Okay.
Okay. Old fuck. Hold on. Shit even with the glasses on.
And notice I'm not wearing mine.
Yeah, I know.
Yesterday I didn't put them on all day until I left the house. I got all the way to my, like, I started driving down the driveway and it's like, wait, I'm missing my glasses. I guess I should wear those.
Anyway, Jackson Thorne here. Well met. Love the show and the community engagement y'all do. friendless me, meh. So, Jackson, I did so, of course.
Thank you for the comments.
Yeah. And appreciate you leaving us feedback. Of course, we ask that you all leave some feedback. Again, you can do it anywhere, folks. You can leave it over on YouTube. You can leave it on Twitch. You can come on in here and chat with us daily and join in on the show as we tell you, we are the only show on the air 5 days a week that invites you to come join us and talk about what's going on.
YouTube says I like a lot of things.
Yeah, I don't want to see what your YouTube suggestion list looks like over there.
Well, for some reason, some Slipknot, but I have not listened to a Slipknot song in a while.
Yeah, well.
My recommendation, it's like Billy Corgan on the realities of being a rock star.
Just don't know.
Yeah.
Don't know.
If they actually played like some of the things in my history, that would probably give a little bit better of an idea. So I don't know why these things are here.
Who knows?
Because I wouldn't click on any of them for the most part. Yeah. Yep.
Go figure. But anyway, yeah. Community live stream, if you've got questions, go ahead, click on the link and post your questions. Currently, there are 0 questions. Doesn't look like anybody wants to know anything about this stuff. I'm shocked. Usually, by the day before, there's loads of questions.
Should I ask when they're going to actually respond to my
your player challenge?
My dev challenge?
If you want to be the first and get it in there, make sure that it's almost absolutely red. Why not?
Yeah, hold on.
Of course, they'll just roll right over that because they'll say it has nothing to do with player-made dungeons. Tell them, sure it does. My crafting station's in the dungeon, damn it. I hadn't thought about that. Can we put the crafting stations down in the dungeon? I guess we can. I guess it's deco, right? I guess dungeons are now the new big basements. Uh-oh. Jack's issuing a challenge.
When will a dev complete the crafting challenge that I issued?
Yeah, too much.
Craft 100 of each scroll type from the base materials, which means you have to convert the wood scrap to wood pulp and then craft the scrolls.
First question.
Should I do it?
Why not? You really want to see an answer? Let's see.
There you go.
Craft the wood pulp. Harvesting, we say you can buy the wood, wood scrap. You can buy the wood scrap.
They can cheat to get it, gathering all the materials. I don't care about that aspect of it. But the actual crafting, I want them to do it.
Because it takes forever.
Yeah. It's like, The question is, will they actually do it without cheating?
Yeah, I don't think that actually would do anything there.
What?
the con. This is with no time skew, slowing down time, speeding up time. That just speeds up motion. I don't think that actually speeds up anything else.
Well, they do have all kinds of GM speed hacks. So, yeah. They can cheat.
No cheating.
There is a GM command for them speeding up the crafting significantly. So, yeah. That would be hilarious.
Tell you what we're going to do. I'm going to click that button. Cha-ching!
Wait. Someone did donate things, so I should...
But you should open
this.
Up a giveaway as well, just because...
Giveaway is open for...
Eagle was quite generous today. Thank you, Eagle. And, of course, don't forget to... For all you other folks out there who may want to donate,
you know what? Actually, I'm gonna make it even easier. I'm gonna close this giveaway. I'm gonna reset it. I'm going to make it bang. I love this shit just for lasso on both.
So both of them are bang. I love this shit, so they don't get confused.
Yeah. And then open giveaway. So, bang, I love this shit to join on my stream.
There you go. I love this shit. I tell you, I do. Yeah. I do. You know how much I love this shit? We had it put on the bumper sticker. That's how much I love this shit. I tell you what.
And the real question is, why is it not registering people?
I don't know. Are they... I love this shit.
Oh wait. Sorry. I fucked up. I forgot the I. Reset. Hold on.
No.
I love
technical
this shit.
Difficulties.
Now it's open properly.
Stand by.
I love this shit. Yeah. Yep. I'm in my own giveaway. Awesome.
And
hey, just because that exclamation mark looks just like an I upside down doesn't mean it does. It looks just like
get yourselves in giving away some scrolls here. Thanks to you viewers out there, we do appreciate you. Just a little gesture, something we didn't do the first couple years, but
We did do all kinds of giveaways.
We did some crazy stuff early on. The phrase that pays. We gave away quite a bit of physical merch, thanks to folks like Relics by Real Sir Frank and
others. Gave away a lot of cash. Yeah.
Gave away back in the day. We gave away several
information. It doesn't even say it.
I'm gonna say, did you wind up with a handful of expired authorization codes?
Yeah, I still have a handful of CD keys for the game. Yeah, but remember, I was also giving away Steam keys that I purchased.
Yes.
So it's like, and I still have a couple of Steam keys that I purchased that I have never done anything with.
No longer necessary. Wonder what happens if you try those. Just curious.
just shows that I have a $45 account.
Adds value to the account, absolutely, for future purchase. Okay, yeah.
Yeah. For some reason, Streamlabs chatbot does not announce if you enter the giveaway for some reason.
It should. Red Hammers, thank you for the follow.
Simon, Thradia, Maynard, and Caffeine are currently entered on my stream. So,
hey, we got loads of people entered over on this side. So, of course, don't forget, easier to win on his channel because nobody
definitely over definitely. There. Nobody watches my channel.
Nobody watches Jack's channel.
Well, it's so much better because you don't have to listen to Laz on my channel. Because he cuts out. Because
I cut out, right?
Yeah. So if you don't want to listen to Laz, listen to my channel. Yeah, so we do have the fun part about the stand-up corner, to where they've posted today's stand-up corner.
I saw that, and
yeah, it's still no Tuesday.
Is still no Tuesday, but I like what Wizard Smoke's up to here. So,
which day are we going to read, today or yesterday?
Yeah, we might as well just read today. He's up on it. Okay. Tomorrow's Friday. We never know tomorrow where the hell Friday goes. I don't think we ever get Friday's stand up to begin with. So
sometimes we do, sometimes we don't.
So
sometimes
we might as well wing it. There. We've got this today, and. I just want you to scroll back and look at yesterday's stand-up for Damon, and then look at today's, so then you'll understand.
Okay. Yeah. So don't forget, stand-up corners where the devs say, hey, I worked on this yesterday, I'm working on this today. Something random gets written down, eventually things get posted to the interwebs, and we get to interpret it, so you don't have to.
That's right.
I really need to take a picture of the playroom.
You give that to me, we'll put it out in a tweet one day.
Jack's playroom.
we won't say anything. It'll just be one of the pictures one day that shows up.
Jack's playroom. That or like take my camera in there. Yeah. Damon. He's working on torture-themed decorations. Oh, my. Then over in design, Beezus working on food recipes for lava fish and tweaking taming collars. Wait. Mom said something. What did Mom say? That she's got a very good point. If they get annoyed and speed up their crafting, it just proves your point. Yeah, it does. Bugs.
Bug.
Sanyo working on Envy Angel quest bugs.
Bug.
And polish. And resource node bug fixing.
Bug.
And release 63 player instructions. We should be seeing a draft of that very, very soon.
Soon?
Yes. The Energy Vortex Listrostov is working on dungeon rooms.
Dungeon rooms today?
Yeah, I definitely should send him pictures of the playroom, just so that way he's got some good ideas on what it should look like.
Okay, this just got better. So are we going to give that to a certain developer to use as the basis
as a model?
Yeah. See how much he adopts it to make it look exactly like said room.
Yeah. Oh, the draft was posted yesterday. Yeah, didn't see it.
Did not.
Reading it now.
Okay, then he was also working on. I don't know who was I talking about. Miscellaneous deco tweaks and bugs.
Bug.
Then over in tech, Dr. Bob. Working on bugs.
Bug.
And development server setup and maintenance. And then JY. Working on the Crown store. Maybe he should be working on drinking some Crown while working on the store. It might help things. Working on the development server setup and maintenance. Wizard Smokey's puff puff passing around. The Crown Store bugs.
Bug.
And polish. Then the Deathbringer one and only working on performance. And dungeon. And the dungeon preview shader bugs.
Bug.
Yes, and then the Burning Toad working on development server setup and maintenance and QA builds.
Come on, QA. Should be up here anytime soon as well. Didn't look at that yet. Let's take cool.
Hold on. QA server. Let's refresh. QA server. QA server still offline. For internal testing only. Oops, that's patch notes. Then over in Useless Overhead, Lord British is working on General Bidness and playing the game. The Dippy Bird working on development server setup, maintenance, and being sick. and last but not least, we've got the Dippy Bird or the Dork Star working on live stream planning and Jira triage and Q2 planning. Yep. And that's what our devs said they were working on today.
Hey.
Today. Yeah. We definitely need a puff puff pass emote.
Indeed. I'm surprised that Gixie didn't get something like that in while he was having fun playing with the emotes.
Don't forget to bang I love this shit on my stream.
Bang I love this shit. That's right. Yeah. Exclamation I love this shit. Get yourself in on a chance to win scrolls from both Jack and I on our streams here. Of course, people eating up those scrolls. The hot commodity out there, those teleport the zone scrolls. And again, they're moving. That's that much I know.
Yeah, they are. I had a few... I really need to get back to crafting. Yesterday, I spent a few hours converting scrap. A few hours. A
few hours?
Yeah.
Spent the whole night standing there on the lot?
Well, it was the afternoon. The night I left and... yeah.
Go to happy hour at Chewy's.
No, that's going to be tonight. that's tonight. Yeah.
Alrighty. What else do we have here? What else do we got for the good folks? Of course, got to give a shout out to the marketplace, Shroud Marketplace, because. I love getting ready to go to bed and having to stay up an extra half hour to make a delivery and answer questions. Oh, yeah. But, you know,
yes.
I love this shit. Of course, that was our newcomer out there getting in on the game. That was, what the hell's his name again?
The chick's name. I hate to say it like that, but yeah.
He's Archangel streaming, but his in-game Gabby. Name is Gabby. Yeah, he's got Gabby. Gabby picked up a couple things, made an offer, used the make an offer feature, and picked himself up some cool stuff from some old telethons. And of course, don't forget the market.
Did he get the ether helmet one, so that way he's got the mobile headset?
He got, you know, did the ether helmet come with the radio? I don't know if that...
not the ether.
He got the obsidian bundle, and he got the ether bundles.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Because he really wanted that dye box.
A radio.
He wanted to have that nice glowing dye. I use that cycling dye... on the edges of my stuff. My kicks down here got that ether dye.
Yeah, I noticed last night or yesterday afternoon that you've got the eye behind you that's puffing out the smoke.
You're just now noticing that? That's been there for like months to give me that green glow behind me. I've got one over on the other lot as well, you know.
Yeah, you realize neither one of us pay much attention to anything.
Huh? What? I do, see? And then when I do that and I switch over, then I really glow here at night, man. Just lights me up with this real cool, eerie glow. Because we can, I don't know. Yes. <Yep. clears throat> We even have outfits for the show, if you guys didn't know that. That's right. We actually get dressed and change clothes just for the show every day. Sometimes.
Yeah.
But, moving right along. Tomorrow's live stream, get your questions in now, because there's only one question ahead of you now, and that's Jack's challenge. So.
Yeah,
you've got two more questions. You've got two more. You're allowed to ask three.
Yes. So, what should my other craft things be?
Oh, I don't know.
With the introduction of the teleport to zone scroll, are we going to see a change
in the teleport to friend
scroll, where it function, where it teleports directly to where your friend was standing? Otherwise, it is pretty useless.
Yeah, well, I like both only because if you haven't been to a zone and your friend is there, you can go directly to the friend. But many of us, of course, as soon as the new change came out, first thing we did was run around and jump into every single scene we could.
Yeah.
So that we could travel throughout the world. I mean, I know I've got an extensive list. I covered the majority of the four corners and center, as well as a lot of the Hidden Veil. So I can pretty much go all to my regular haunts without having to worry about whether there's somebody there anymore. That's my life these days. Again, I do like the new system, but I still say we need a gate spell. Really handy for those dance parties. Yeah. And for those dungeon crawls. Yeah.
Well, that would also be the fix to teleport to friend, to where it teleports directly to someone. And although gate spell would also serve that purpose as well.
You know, get the whole party together and everybody jump.
Yep.
Gotta have it. Puff, puff. Intense. Puff, puff. Come on, guys. You know.
What about a PvP faction system?
Well, there's been a long time talk of factions and all that stuff, and we hope to see that here soon enough.
I would love to see that. I mean, especially as they start fleshing out like some castle siege scenarios and actually make it, you've got to find a way to make something a little bit different. Because
there he is, Gabby Johnson. Yeah. That's the man we're talking about.
Where is he?
Just came in.
I don't see him.
Hello.
Are you
trying to get his mic working there? There he is.
Came inside of Discord. Hey,
yes.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. Are you guys streaming? Well,
we are live on NBNN right now. We're just mentioning the marketplace and how you had made your purchases and were enjoying your new trinkets last night. And,
yeah.
Because that's what we do around here. No.
Oh, yeah. They're very nice. I'm enjoying them very much.
Very cool. Very cool. But meanwhile, of course, it's about that time that we pay some bills around here. Past that time. You know, there is no script. You know, nobody says we got to do this at a certain time, but we do got to get it in from day to day. But before I tell you about the NBNN Trinity Avatar app, let me remind you one more time. Exclamation, I love this shit in either of our streams for a chance to get yourself in on some free scrolls given away by both of us today. So total chance to win 40 scrolls, just like Caffeine did the other day. He banged both of them out, won both raffles back-to-back. I'm telling you what, he hit the big number. If I were him, I would have went and played the lottery that day. But the NBNN Trinity Avatar app is available in the Google Play Store, the Apple iTunes Store, or the Amazon App Store, because that's right, yes I did. I made sure that we were in all the stores for all your electronic devices, including an HTML5 version on the web if you don't have any electronic devices. Because if you want to take Shroud of the Avatar with you, whenever you go, wherever you go, how you go.
Yep.
Get your hands on the app. You too can be reading the NBNN Daily Britannian, published 7 days a week with news from Shroud of the Avatar and beyond. You can tune into the radio stations. You can catch the daily podcast if you miss us live. You can shop the marketplace. You can hit the forums. You can check the maps, or you can find out what's going on on the NBNN Shroud of the Avatar community calendar, which is brought to us each and every day by our good friends over at hometownhero.com for all your vape juice needs. Save 20% off your purchase. Promo code NBNN, hometownhero.com.
That's right. Go to NBNN.info, click on the calendar button. You too can look at this aggregated mess.
Big mess.
Is the NBNN Shroud of the Avatar community calendar. And once you do that,
People have been listening. Calendars being cleaned up.
Yes, I love it when people clean up their calendars. I really do. Don't you love it when they clean up their calendars?
Hey, you know, it makes life a lot easier, yeah, not just for us, but for the audience, the general public, and of course, for those folks holding their events. Keep your events that are relevant in the news. If they're not relevant, get them out of the news. Otherwise, people won't come to your events in the future.
Yeah. Exactly, because they won't know if your event's real or not. But don't forget, if you want your Google public calendar hooked up, you need to message or email news@nbnn.info or message Laz in Discord.
This guy.
You'll get it hooked up as long as it's a public calendar, not a private calendar. Or if you want to add one-off events to the NBNN Shroud of the Avatar community calendar, right there.
Also reach out.
Then you need to also reach out to that guy. Don't reach out to me because I don't know if I have permission.
He won't do anything for you.
Yeah, and I probably won't do anything. But don't forget, all times on the community calendar are Central Time in the real world, but we prefer to refer to it as Nude Britannia time. Monday through Friday, 12s and 6s around the clock, whenever we feel like doing it. There's a little show called Lunch with Us. You can listen to really two idiots and don't know what the hell they're talking about. 5 o'clock, actually, it's 7 o'clock. Radio Free Britannia. It's the 70s at 7. At 10 p.m. on Avatars Radio, Jerekith Rivenson's going to be doing some Chaotic Country.
Chaotic Country.
I think his featured band for this evening is going to be Obituary. Yeah, so I don't know. Also at 10 p.m. is going to be the Wekod Womb with Waz's Wad Wekod on Wedia Radio Free Britannia.
W-R-F-B.
And I think that's our calendar.
That is. Nice, short, sweet, and to the point.
Very short.
Gotta love it with people keeping up and cleaning up their calendars. My thanks to those of you who have been hearing us say, hey, get your calendars up to date. Appreciate all you doing that, taking a look at it, and of course, keeping them poignant and to the point for everybody out there in the world. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Reminder, like you all didn't know, you're tuned in to NBNN right here on NBNN.info, twitch.tv/Cinesis, twitch.tv/NBNN News. Catching us on Twitch TV or on YouTube. If you hung with us this long and you like what you're seeing and you're enjoying the show, hit the follow buttons, hit the subscribe buttons, hit the notification buttons, you know, all those little buttons down there that you need to do, because it does help us get the word out. It does help bring us income, because we're here thanks to you guys and gals keeping us here, and we do appreciate it. Many ways to donate. You can click on the links that come up on your screen in chat. You can click on the links below. You can donate in cryptocurrency over on Jack's stream. You can cheer live in bits or you can cheer live in cash using the interfaces we've got on the streams like you saw Eagle do today, and you can get your own displays up there. We got all sorts of great options. You can become a patron. Go patreon.com/NBNN. Become a monthly supporter. Amazon Prime account holders, you get a free monthly sub. We appreciate it if you use those every month on our streams. And of course, there's another way. There's all sorts of ways. Just reach out, help. Every little bit counts. Pays for all this great stuff that we do here, and we do appreciate it. Dairyfund.org, bringing you the latest in community causes and charitable events. The Britannia and Mining Company wants you to come check out Black Rock Cove. Open for all your crafting goods needs. If you're looking to open a shop, if you're just looking to hang out with a bunch of like-minded miner-type folks, come out and check out Black Rock Cove, because we do some crazy fun stuff. I tell you, we were out last night having a good time, and don't forget that looking for group, folks. You'll see all sorts of folks out there having a great time. BMC Black Rock Cove, Quell Region, next to Exeter. Go visit, check out their stuff, buy some goods. HometownHero.com for all your vape juice needs. Save 20% off your purchase price at Hometown Hero. Of course, if you want to try before you buy, you go ahead and sign up, send them your email address. You'll pay shipping plus a penny because that's the law. Try your first bottle practically free and check it out. Otherwise, you'll save 20%. Off your purchase, promo code NBNN when you check out at hometownhero.com. Coil More Wands, putting the magic in your hands. Grota's Music Service, putting the music in your ears. That's right. Jack showing you a bottle. I got a bunch of bottles on my desk. We play flavor roulette with them from time to time. Relics by Rill.com.
I play the real flavor roulette.
You play, yeah, all flavor roulette. Relics by Rilled for all your licensed Shroudity Avatar swag. If you're looking for everything from t-shirts to bumper stickers, hats and hoodies, to glassware and coinage, RelicsByRilled.com is the place for you, and we'll save you 10% at Relics by Rilled. Promo code NBNM when you check out. Usually takes care of your shipping costs, so it's almost like getting your shipping free. Of course, WRFB Radio Free Britannia, bringing you the latest news and entertainment 24/7 around the clock, including us at 12s and 6s around the clock, right there on WRFB Radio Free Britannia, on your in-game radios, and on the internet, wrfb.rocksradiofreebritannia.com, if you want to listen when you're not in-game. Of course, last but never, and definitely not least, ShroudMarketplace.com for all your virtual vendable goods, because, hey, one of the other reasons why I love this shit is the marketplace. Allows me to list all my goods, leave them out there, and, when somebody new comes along is looking for some of that good stuff that I have no use for, I've bought to pass on to future generations of players. Well, Shroud Marketplace is there to serve. I love a marketplace.
You know what? Any place that allows you to like register an account, buy stuff from other players, or register as a vendor yourself and sell your things to other players is a great place. And especially considering it's
especially if it's free.
I know it's
practically you're free, right?
Practically, it's. It's all relative. I mean, some fees do come out whenever you do have a sale. That's to pay for the marketplace itself because that stuff's expensive. But you know what? Over 150 different players registered as vendors, and each one of those vendors is responsible for setting their own prices and maintaining their own inventory. So you get all kinds of great stuff out there. Just like, you know what? If you're looking for 1,000 pine wood, it's up for sale from Caffeine.
Makes for a healthy, competitive marketplace. That's for sure. That's my favorite part.
You can always do a search for
scrolls. Keeps the vendors honest.
Yeah, do a search for scrolls, And you can find those teleport scrolls from this guy.
I don't care how you low.
And that guy.
Low. I'm not dropping my prices.
Hey, man. Cheaper over at this guy's shop. Guaranteed not to fizzle. That guy will sell you fizzle insurance for his scrolls.
I'll sell him fizzle insurance for your scrolls.
For my scrolls, too. Yeah,
mine doesn't need insurance.
Anything and everything you can find at Shroud Marketplace, from accounts to game gold, crowns of the obsidian, cheaper than you can get off the add-on store, all the way to services. Anything and everything at Shroud Marketplace. Go check it out.
Yeah, but check it out.
Check out my shop. Check out that guy's shop.
Idea out there.
Check out both our shops, yeah.
Is Kanda says, an idea for crafting speed. Silver Serpent Venom gives you a health debuff or something, but speeds up the refining of things like wood pulp. Really cool idea.
Yeah, but you know what time it is?
I do. It's time to tell them that there are plenty of services out there and much, much more in the marketplace that they can do. And of course, if they're looking to get rid of their goods or they're looking to buy some goods that they missed, they should check out shroudmarketplace.com. Yeah. Yes, Eagle, thank you very much. We do appreciate you taking your hour out every day to join us. And sipping your coffee out of your NBNN coffee mugs, because you rock, man. Thank you very much. And of course, yes, it's that time for us to get out of here. But of course, we do have to take care of that last little bit of business, give away some scrolls. So we're going to go ahead and close those giveaways. Closed.
It is closed.
And we're going
to. You ready to click the magic pick a winner button?
Some winners. Yes. Drum roll, please.
Pick a winner. Simon LeBon.
Oh,
won on mine. Simon LeBon won on both. Congrats, Simon.
Something's getting awfully suspicious here. I don't know.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I only had 8 people in mine. So
yeah, now we got.
I believe you had more in yours, but I need to pull some scrolls real quick so that way I can actually.
We have a bunch more people than that, but congrats, yeah. Simon, as double winner here. Yes, lightning does strike twice.
I know. Two days in a row.
Two people win. I don't know. Maybe we shouldn't be pushing those buttons at the same time.
And we are using
two different bots on two different channels. I know.
Yeah.
That's the weird part.
I use Streamlabs for everything. And so, yeah.
Anyway.
So,
Simon, congratulations. Of course,
yes,
thank you all for tuning in and joining us today. We'll be back with more tomorrow right here on NBNN. Till then. I'm Laz.
I'm Jack.
And we are NBNN. Have a great day, everybody. We'll see you all tomorrow.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Clear.